Imagine stepping outside your door. The sun is shining, birds are singing. But as you walk down the street, something is off. The world around you seems to lag, to stutter. You wave to your neighbor, and their wave back takes a full second to reach you, even though they're just across the lawn. What if this wasn't a glitch in your brain, but a fundamental change in the universe? What if the speed of light, the absolute cosmic speed limit, was a sluggish 100 miles per hour? It's a world where a thrown baseball could break the light barrier. This bizarre new reality wouldn't just make things look weird, it would fundamentally break our modern world, and strangely enough, could even subvert the connection between cause and effect in our global economy. So, what would actually happen? Let's start with the most obvious change. At 100 miles per hour, light is slow. Really slow. You could literally watch a beam of light travel from a streetlight to the ground. Flick a light switch in a large room, and you'd see the wave of illumination wash across the space like a silent glowing tide. Conversations would become interesting. You'd see a person's lips move, but the sound, which now travels much faster than light, would reach you first. This creates a bizarre, out-of-sync world. Like a badly dubbed movie, a lightning strike a mile away. You'd hear the thunder a few seconds later, but you wouldn't see the flash for a full 36 seconds. Think about that. The evidence of an event would arrive long after the event itself. But this is just the tip of the iceberg. The real weirdness begins when we start moving. This is where a guy named Einstein enters the picture. His theory of special relativity tells us that the speed of light is constant for all observers, no matter how fast they are moving. To make that cosmic rule work, something else has to give: time and space itself. If you started jogging at a leisurely pace, say 10 miles per hour, you'd be moving at 10% of the new speed of light, and that's when things get trippy. For you, the jogger, everything would seem normal. But for someone standing still, watching you, your reality would start to warp. First, you would appear to shrink in the direction you're moving. This is not an optical illusion. From an outsider's perspective, you are physically shorter. It's called length contraction. At the same time, your personal clock would start ticking slower. This is time dilation. For every hour that passes for the stationary observer, a little less than an hour would have passed for you. Now, let's push it. Imagine you get in a car and hit the highway, cruising at a cool 87 miles per hour. At that speed, time for you would be ticking at only half the rate of someone standing by the side of the road. You could drive for what feels like an hour to you, but 2 hours would have passed for the rest of the world. You would literally be time traveling into the future. You'd arrive at your destination younger than if you had stayed home. And what happens if you try to break that 100 mph barrier? According to relativity, as you approach the speed of light, your mass increases. It takes more and more energy to accelerate you further. At 99 miles per hour, your mass would be enormous. To actually reach 100 mph, you'd need an infinite amount of energy. The universe itself puts up a roadblock. The speed of light is the ultimate speed limit, and in this world, it's a very slow one. This relativistic weirdness would bring our entire civilization to a grinding halt. Think about our digital world. Every single piece of data, every email, every video call, every financial transaction is sent as pulses of light through fiber optic cables. At 100 mph, sending a message from New York to London would take over a day and a half. The internet as we know it would cease to exist. Real-time global communication would be impossible. Your GPS utterly useless. The system works by triangulating signals from satellites, and those calculations depend on the speed of light being incredibly fast and constant. With our new slow light speed, your phone wouldn't just be slightly off. It would place you in a different city entirely. This leads to a terrifying question. If information can only travel at 100 miles per hour, how could we maintain a global economy? Think about the stock market. Trades are executed in fractions of a second based on information zipping around the world at, well, the speed of light. In our new reality, a market crash in Tokyo wouldn't be known in New York for hours, or even days. By the time the news arrived, it would be ancient history. Here's that scenario I mentioned at the beginning. The link between cause and effect would be broken. An investor in London could make a decision based on today's prices, but the execution of that trade wouldn't happen until tomorrow. The information is simply too slow. This delay, this information lag, would create chaos. It would be impossible to have a stable, interconnected financial system. The global economy wouldn't just stumble, it would shatter. But the consequences go even deeper, right down to the nature of reality itself. Colors, for example, would become shifty and unreliable. The color we see depends on the wavelength of light. As you move towards a light source, the light waves bunch up, shifting towards the blue end of the spectrum, move away, and they stretch out, shifting red. We call this the Doppler effect. In our world, you have to be moving at incredible speeds for this to be noticeable. But at 100 metpulse light speed, just walking towards a red stop sign could make it appear green. Walking away from a green light could make it look red. Imagine the traffic chaos. The universe would be a constant kaleidoscope of shifting colors based on your every movement. Even the sun would look different. It's about 93 million miles away. At the true speed of light, its light takes about 8 minutes to reach us. But at 100 mantazai, it would take over 106 years. That means the sunlight warming your face today would have left the sun in the early 1920s. You would be looking at a ghost, an image of the sun as it was more than a century ago. And because the earth is moving, the sun wouldn't even appear to be where it actually is. We'd see it in one spot in the sky, while its gravitational pull would be coming from its real, invisible position. This would fundamentally alter everything, from how plants grow to how we evolved. Life on Earth evolved with fast light. Our eyes, our brains, our entire biology is built on the assumption that what we see is what is happening right now. In a slow light world, would we have even evolved eyes? Or would we rely more on other senses like hearing or touch that are now faster than sight? It's a world so alien, it's hard to truly comprehend. From a world that simply looks lagged, we've journeyed to a reality where time itself breaks, where our global civilization crumbles, and the very fabric of our universe feels like shifting sand. The simple act of slowing down light unravels everything we take for granted. It reveals that the speed of light isn't just a number, it's the master architect of our reality. It dictates the relationship between space and time, cause and effect, and ultimately, what we perceive as the now. Our universe, with its dizzyingly fast light speed, imprisons us. We can never travel faster. Never escape its ultimate limit. But it also gives us a profound gift, a stable, coherent reality. A world where a wave is returned in an instant, where the sun we see is the sun that warms us, and where the world responds as quickly as we can perceive it. In a strange way, by being the fastest thing there is, light allows our world to feel solid, real, and instantaneous, and that might be the most incredible special effect of all.